Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the Flame 2018.3 update, you now have the ability to export embedded multi-channel OpenEXRs. This long-time requested functionality allows you to establish a round-trip workflow between other applications utilizing multi-channel EXRs. The idea is that any multi-channel EXRs you import into Flame, or even multi-channel media that you create in Flame, can be exported out in a multi-channel OpenEXR. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the displayed link in your favorite web browser. So go ahead and import all the downloaded media into an empty Reels group. Now these clips have been newly imported into Flame, but this media could also have been generated by rendering different media passes from batch. It actually makes no difference. The method you're about to use is the same in either case. To create a multi-channel EXR export, you'll use a new sequence and version tracks to define each multi-channel pass. So call up the contextual menu on the sequences reel and create a new sequence. You can call it by any name and set your resolution according to your needs. This media is 16-bit, but it could also be 32-bit if required. Disable the audio tracks as you won't need them. Create the new sequence. Now drag the beauty pass or camera footage onto the first version track called V1. Note that the description in the segment will become the actual name of the multi-channel pass in the exported file. So this is essentially the first channel for the EXR. To add more channels, just add a few more version tracks to the sequence. In this case, add 4 more version tracks. Next, drag each clip to a different version track. You are essentially using a sequence to establish the structure of the multi-channel EXR when it is exported. Now these clips were mostly mats, and the last one was a motion vector pass. In terms of use cases, you could use the multi-channel export to contain multiple mats in a file, which in turn could be used for compositing or grading purposes. The same goes for data passes such as the motion vector pass. You can contain any channels you like in the multi-channel export for a variety of uses within your production pipeline. So that's how easy it is to build the multi-channel EXR structure. Now to export a multi-channel EXR, it's also pretty quick and easy. Switch to the Media Hub. Now navigate to the folder where you'd like to place the exported media. Pick up your multi-version track sequence and drop it into the file browser. The media export window appears, and you can choose to export a file sequence. Inside the format presets, you can choose any flavor of OpenEXR that you'd like to export in. Now click Show Advanced Options. In the Video Options tab, you will see a button called Multi-Channel. When this is off, Flame will just export a RGBA file and ignore all the other version tracks. When Multi-Channel is enabled, it will now consider the entire version track structure and produce a multi-channel OpenEXR. You can also go ahead and configure the naming of the media. You can export in the foreground or background, and the result will be the same. Click Export. The media exports, and you should now have a new clip in the file browser that contains a multi-tag. If you look at the preview window, you can switch to the Metadata tab, and Flame registers that there are multi-channels in the embedded EXR, and you can scroll through the list to identify them. As a more visual way of seeing the multi-channels, just double-click the multi-tag on the clip, and all the embedded multi-channels will be exposed in the browser. There is the beauty pass, the three mats, and the motion vector pass. You can import this back into Flame as a multi-channel clip, or pass it along to another VFX or grading application that uses multi-channel data as part of your round-tripping workflow. Please be sure to check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.